Is that knocking at the house of Mouse? We're all knocking at the house of Mouse. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're all rocking at the house of Mouse. We're having a ball and rocking the hall. So come on in,
to the house of Mouse.
Party just started, so come on in. The good times are all just about to begin. Step inside, we're gonna have some fun. There's plenty of room here for everyone.
The gang's all here and we're hanging out.
All this fun makes you jump and shout. Hey, little girl, I wanna dance with you.
We'll find so many things to do.
So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're having a ball.
The house of Mouse.
When you therefore shall see the abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet stand in a holy place, whoso readeth, let him understand.
What were they thinking? What were they thinking? What were they thinking?
What were they thinking?
What were they thinking?
What were they thinking? What were they thinking?
Stood up for what he believed was right.
When you're watching Superbook, you're not just watching an animated Bible story. You're also watching one of the most accurate portrayals of the ancient Middle East ever put into a cartoon.
It appears we are in ancient Babylon, approximately 500 BC.
Every detail and every shot has been checked for historical accuracy, from the clothes to the armor, even down to the tapestries in the background. If they didn't have it back then, they're not going to have it in Superbook.
What could possibly be so important?
Here's an example. Take a look at this shot. It's only up there for a few seconds, so if you blink, you might miss it. Now, that massive blue structure is called the Ishtar Gate. It was built by King Nebuchadnezzar in 575 BC and faithfully reconstructed by our Superbook animators 2,500 years later. Now, believe it or not, that gate is still around, only it's not in Babylon anymore. It's now standing in a museum in Germany. Our producers saw the gate and made sure that when we drew it, we had the right colors, the right size, and all those lions on the wall facing in the right direction.
And the reason is we want to let children know that this is a real place and a real time, and this is an historical event that happened.
And it's not just the backgrounds.
What is the meaning of this outrage?
Take this handsome fellow. His name is Darius the Great. He was the reigning monarch of the Persian Empire between 522 and 486 BC. He's believed to be the guy in charge of Babylon in the years after the Jewish exile, and he's also thought to be the Darius referred to in the Book of Daniel.
You are wise above all men in my kingdom.
Well, we didn't just draw him to sport the ZZ Top beard because it was cool. That's actually the way he looked.
Even a king can be uncertain about what is right.
The more historically accurate we can make them, the longer the series will last.
But it's not just the look that's important. The foundation of any Superbook episode is the Bible story, whether it's Daniel in the lion's den or Moses or creation. We want to be sure that the story that's being told by us matches up with the story being told in the Bible, even down to the dialogue, which comes directly from the scriptures.
Long live the king!
My God sent his angel to shut the lion's mouth so they would not hurt me, for I have been found innocent in his sight.
Ultimately, the goal of Superbook is to teach kids around the world about the Bible. That's why this series will be translated into 18 languages. We hope that in the next few years, 300 million children will hear stories from Genesis to Revelation through Superbook, and many of those kids will be hearing about the Bible for the first and only time through this program. That's why we're such a stickler for accuracy. We just added the talking robot.